Welcome to ragurkul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create test cases using OpenAI. We'll give you outline how we can build the test cases in detail, so please be available from start to end of this video. While creating the test cases, it's a very painful task for any software testing engineer. To do that, we can definitely save 5x time taking help with ChatGPT or OpenAI. When we wanted to build the test cases, rather than writing each and everything manually, better we can use OpenAI or ChatGPT to get at least outline. And once the outline is there, we can build our end-to-end test cases. At the end of this video, I will give you some important tips which will be helpful for you to make your test cases even better. So please be available from start to end of this video. Now, to start with this, let me just write it down. Test cases for login page. Now, let's go one by one. It's already provided a lot of test cases, but here it's just on the scenario based, where you can see valid credentials, enter correct username and password, ensures the login is successful or not. Case insensitivity, it means enter the username and password with different cases, uppercase, lowercase, or mixed case. Ensure the system accepts them as the same. Remember me functionality if it is available. So here, login with the remember me option checked. Close the browser and reopen it to see if the system retains the login sessions. Password visibility, it means toggle password visibility while typing the password. Ensuring the password is visible when toggled and hidden when not. So if it is available, then timeout sessions. So login and left the sessions timeout. It means once you log in, keep the session idle. Post that if you are not doing any activity after login on any applications, if this timeout session is enabled, the application itself will log out for you. This is majorly required for the security point of view or compliance point of view, so that you cannot lose any of your important data from this applications. Multiple concurrent sessions. If you're trying to log in from the different locations, is it working or not? Negative test cases are invalid username and password, empty fields, SQL injections, cross-site scripting, then brute force attack, which means attempt multiple login attempts with incorrect credentials within a short time frame. This should block your credentials or give you a message. Try to reach out to the administrator. Next is verify the system detects the blocks or thwarts these attempts. Account locked, session fixations, all those scenarios will be nicely generated. But here, when we are using it, might be it's some of the functionality is not there, like remember me or session timeout or brute force attack. So that is verifying the system detects and blocks or throttles these attempts. Account lockout, enter incorrect credentials multiple times, might be lockout or might be not. Browser compatibility, definitely the browser compatibility will be a major issues. If we are not having, definitely we have to make sure of it. So this will give you scenario based. But if I want this login page test cases, all positive and negative test cases of login page with steps, expected result, priority in tabular format. Now here you can see once I enter all those details, again this will give you a proper outline. This is not just a scenario based. This will give you a proper outline in tabular formats. I just mentioned steps, expected results, and priority. If you want to add or remove any of those fields, you can also do that. So positive test cases are valid credentials where enter correct username, successfully login with corresponding user details, which is high priority. Enter correct password, again, is same. Case insensitivity is a medium. Here you can see two steps are there. Negative test cases, you can see invalid username and password, again it's high, where you can see enter incorrect username, enter incorrect password, and try to see are you able to log in or not. So this is how we can generate the test cases in tabular format. If you want to add or remove any of those columns, you can add it. Even you can generate test data for same. So here I will just write generate test data for above test cases in tabular format. So by using ChatGPT or OpenAI, you can quickly see this positive test case test data is generated and negative test case test data is also generated. So this is how we can generate a very quickly test data. And whenever it is required, you can just copy and paste into your Excel file and modify it, which is very quick enough where you can do it. Let's consider I wanted to generate the test cases for Amazon website. Now here, when I entered these fields, right, description, steps, expected result, priority, and status. This is including or creating test cases for Amazon website. And here you can see each and everything is highlighted. It's not mandatory. It's important to make sure just copy and paste it into your Word or Excel file and modify it according to your requirement. It might be happen. It will not generate all the test cases. So even after that, you can elaborate more or expand more with the help of OpenAI itself. But at least you got an idea how you can create the test cases with the OpenAI even in tabular format, which is important enough where it will save a lot of your time and effort while creating these test cases. So here you can see user registration is the main or first options. It has generated the test cases for user registrations, search functionality, which can involve basic search, advanced search, and filter search, where you can apply the filter on each of this product. Product details page, which involve view product details, add product to cart, checkout processes, proceed to checkout, select delivery address, choose payment method, and place order. Let's consider I want to add all test cases of checkout process for above example. Now you can see here it start including all those test cases required for the checkout processes, which is much quicker and easier enough. I will repeat again, it's not mandatory. You can copy paste and use it. Definitely you have to modify it, and once the modification is done according to your product, it is good to start or good to go. So here, don't rely 100% on the AI. Reason behind it, these are the tools, or these are the OpenAI tool working on algorithm basis or working on the history of the data. So whatever data is available into their database, based on that, it's showing us the result. So that's the reason it's always make sure to add your own effort as well, but definitely not 100%. 20-30% of the efforts will be required from your side where you can do the modifications. But trust me, this will save a lot of your time and efforts while creating these test cases. Now, the important tips is while creating these test cases, always try to give as much as informations you have, because based on that, it will generate the test cases. And even while creating the test data, don't just write it down, give me test data. Add which all fields are there, like test boxes, radio buttons, input parameters, all those factors, you can define it and you will get a very descriptive test data as well. Third and very most important part is don't just copy and paste it and share with your superiors. It will create a bad impressions for you on your superiors, because it is randomly generating these test cases. Here you have to just copy it and make it according to your products or according to your requirements. Modifications will be required, so better to modify. And fourth is, whenever you are copying and pasting these data, make sure to align it according to your product functionality as well. Once you will do all four, or you will follow all four tips, your test case will be looks like in better format. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. And if you wanted to learn more about software testing and OpenAI, feel free to add in the comment sections your topic name, We'll be happy to add or create the video related to that based on the demand. Thank you for watching.